If I ever need to create a wiring diagram for a data logger station that is already programmed in making measurements, but no wiring documentation is available, there are a few ways to do that. In this video, I'll show how to use Shortcut for Windows to create a wiring diagram that matches my current system. Shortcut for Windows, also known as SCWin, is a free menu-driven software package that simplifies the creation of data logger programs. Part 3 of the CR1000X Getting Started video series is a great introduction to SCWin. Before I can create a wiring diagram to match an existing program, I need to know what sensors are connected to the data logger and the colors of the individual sensor wires. I also need to know which channel on the wiring panel each wire is connected to. If that information is not available, I may need to make a site visit to take notes and photos of the system. Ideally, information about the sensors and wiring is in the notes for the data logger program. The program can be downloaded using the Retrieve Program button in PC400 or in the LoggerNet Connect screen. Sometimes the program notes don't contain that information, but there are clues in the variable names, program instructions, and data field names that can help deduce the wiring. I'll cover that in a future video in this series. For this demonstration, assume that I have a photo of my data logger wiring panel and have verified sensor model numbers by looking at information printed on the body of each sensor and in some cases on a label near the end of the sensor cable. My CR1000X is measuring a CS301 pyranometer, a 05103 wind monitor, a TE525 rain gauge, a Hygrove U10 temperature and relative humidity sensor, and a Taros 11 soil water content sensor. All I need to do now is add these sensors in a new SCWin program and make sure the wiring matches the information I already have. I won't send the new program I generate. This exercise is just to create the wiring diagram for a program that already exists. SCWin automatically selects the lowest channel number available that can do the job, so it's best to start adding sensors to the program starting at the upper left of the wiring panel and working towards the right. My photo of the wiring panel shows that the sensor connected to channel 1H has white, black, and clear wires. Two of my sensors have wiring with those colors, CS301 and the TE525. If I'm not sure which one is connected to channel 1H, I can make a guess and see where SCWin places the wires. I'll start by typing TE525 in the sensor search box. Four different models of rain gauge are found. Mine is the TE525, so I double-click that. That opens a configuration window for the TE525. I want to see how SCWin assigned the wiring, so I select the Wiring tab. The wiring information shows that SCWin wants to connect the black wire to P1 and the white wire to ground. That doesn't match what I see for channel 1H, so I know that the first sensor can't be the TE525 rain gauge. I select Cancel to close this window. Next, I try searching for the CS301 and double-click that to open the configuration window. This time, the wiring tab shows me a white wire at 1H and a black wire at ground. This matches the wiring for my station, so I select OK. Now I will add the 05103 wind monitor. I search for that and double-click it to open the window. The wiring tab shows me a green wire going to channel 1L. But my photo shows the green wire going to channel 2L. To make my wiring diagram match the actual wiring, I click on 1L to open a wire location window. From the drop-down menu, I select 2L and OK. Now my wiring tab shows the green wire connected to 2L. The rest of the wires listed on the wiring tab match my photo, so I select OK. The next sensor on my wiring panel is connected to P2 and ground. When I tried the TE525 earlier, SCWin assigned the black wire to P1. Since that has been claimed for the 05103, SCWin now assigns the black wire P2. Make sure the wires match the photo. They do, so I select OK. Moving down to the bottom terminal strip, I see a white wire in channel C1. When I search for the Hygrove U10 and double-click it, the wiring tab tells me that SCWin assigned the brown wire to 12V, the white wire to C1, and the black wire to G. My sensor doesn't have a blue or gray wire. This matches my photo, so I select OK. The wiring diagram created by SCWin is almost finished. In the next video, I'll demonstrate how to add a sensor that is not found in SC-WIN's list of sensors to the wiring diagram.